Warner Bros. Discovery is set to add more AEW content to their networks, and several free agents are backstage at AEW Dynamite. But first, we have an update on the New Japan status of Carl Anderson. This past Monday on Raw, the Good Brothers would make their WWE return to provide backup for AJ Styles, who has found himself feuding with Finn Balor and the Judgment Day. This was their first appearance in WWE since their release in April 2020 at the height of the pandemic, shortly after their involvement in the main event of WrestleMania Night 1 in the Boneyard match, once again backing up AJ Styles against The Undertaker. One of the most surprising aspects of the return is the fact that one half of the Good Brothers, Carl Anderson, is still the current never openweight champion in New Japan Pro Wrestling, and is scheduled to defend his belt next month against Hikaleo on November 5th at Battle Autumn in Osaka, leading many to speculate if he'll work for both companies for the time being. It seems that the match is still in New Japan's plans, as they would release an update card for the show the next morning, with the never openweight match still being listed. Well, on top of their prior report noting that the Good Brothers had known of interest from WWE whilst under contract with Impact Wrestling, Fightful Select would update their post, adding that Anderson still expects to work with New Japan through to Wrestle Kingdom 17 this January, and that WWE gave New Japan a heads up before the surprise return. And Fightful would note, Carl Anderson claims to Fightful that he's still planning on working the Tokyo Dome show. Also, we're told by those in WWE that New Japan was given a heads up. Interestingly, the number one contender for Anderson's title, Hikaleo, would take to Twitter to ask if he is hiding from him, with this being retweeted by the New Japan Global Twitter account. Whether this is a sign that NJPW and WWE will be working together remains to be seen, but it seems that in the short term, there will be some talent crossover until January 4th, with Anderson and maybe even Gallows working there until Wrestle Kingdom. What makes this even more interesting is the partnership between New Japan and AEW, with WWE and AEW talent likely to work on the same shows in the next few months. But do you think this could be the start of something bigger between WWE and New Japan, or is it just a one-off with the Good Brothers? Let me know in the comments down below. And next, Matt Cardona has discussed a potential WWE return. In a news video earlier today, we discussed the potential return of Chelsea Green to WWE, where they're said to be heading back to the company following her release in April 2021. One person left out of the report was Green's real-life husband, Matt Cardona, with the two having been a key part of each other's acts during their time on the independent circuit as of late, becoming one of the hottest duos on the scene. While speaking with Alistair McGeorge of Metro this week, Cardona would discuss whether he would be interested in a move back to WWE were the opportunity to arise, and he would admit that whilst he'd like to have a WrestleMania moment again, he's not actively trying to get back to the company. And he would say, I'm not trying to get back to WWE, but I'd be lying if I said I never wanted to have a WrestleMania moment again, or never wanted to wrestle at Madison Square Garden. Of course I would. If Triple H called me right now, if I had that 203, that's the area code for Stamford, Connecticut, of course I'd pick up. But right now I'm focusing on being the best me possible, and having the most fun possible, and making the most money possible. He would then credit WWE for setting him up for the run of his career over the last 2 years, with him becoming one of, if not the highest drawing independent wrestlers, using his WWE fame to draw significant heel heat. And he would add, if I didn't have WWE, I wouldn't have this canvas to paint on, so to speak. WWE set me up for that, and I've said since I left WWE, I'm not trying to prove anybody wrong. I don't have a chip on my shoulder. I'm just trying to prove myself right and my fans right. The former GCW and NWA World Champion would then note that you don't need to be in AEW or WWE to be successful, although he thinks about the WWE Championship every day, with him noting, right now I'm trying to prove that you don't necessarily need to be in WWE or AEW to be a successful pro wrestler. But of course, the WWE Championship is something I think about every single day when I wake up. That is definitely always on my mind. I'd be lying if I said it wasn't. I think if you're in this business, to be a world champion is the goal you should have, and for me personally, it's the bees, the WWE Championship. It's been so much fun, it's been such a creative outlet, and it's my favourite 2 years in my almost 20-year career, which is pretty incredible. I worked for WWE for 14 years, which is the top of the wrestling world, and my favourite 2 years of the business have been afterwards. It's been so much fun, and I can't wait for what's next. Cardona is now set to challenge to win back his NWA World Heavyweight Championship at NWA Hard Times 3 on November 12th, taking on champion Trevor Murdoch as well as Tyrus in a triple threat match for the belt. Whether he has a future back in WWE remains to be seen, but given his trajectory since leaving back in early 2020, I'd say it was a matter of time before one of the two big US promotions snap him up, with him perhaps finding a spot alongside Chelsea Green in WWE in the near future. And next, Warner Bros. Discovery are set to add more AEW content to their network. Ever since the merger of Discovery and Warner Media in April, AEW have continued to cross-promote with other brands under the Warner Bros. Discovery umbrella. Despite speculation of the contrary, Warner have shown signs of trust in AEW as a brand, with an important executive now speaking out on the situation with their resident wrestling promotion. This week, Kathleen Finch, Warner Bros. Discovery US Network's Group Chair and Chief Content Officer, would speak with the Hollywood Reporter, where she discussed how TNT and TBS maintain a strong male audience night to night, with her citing sports as the key, with her having huge praise for All Elite Wrestling in particular, and Finch would say, "We really play into the sports space. One of the things that we're doing around sports is creating shoulder programming to hold onto those fans. All Elite Wrestling pulls huge numbers, so we are working with the wrestling team. What new kind of content can we build that's not in a wrestling ring?" Of course, Warner currently airs AEW Rampage on TNT, whilst AEW Dynamite airs on TBS, and it looks like we may be set to see more shoulder content similar to the Roads to the Top series that we saw in late 2021, which was centered around Brandy and Cody Rhodes. There has been reports noting that Darby Allin has been working on a reality project as of late, which could be the first of many new shows centered around the stars of All Elite Wrestling. But what side content would you like to see Warner produce around the world of AEW? Let me know in the comments down below. And finally, several free agents are backstage at AEW Dynamite. This week, AEW head to Toronto, Canada for their first ever internationally based show with a live taping of Dynamite tonight, with a pre-taped edition of Rampage being filmed on Thursday night for airing on Friday. With that said, it looks like they are set to take a look at some local Canadian talent, with there said to be at least three indie wrestlers backstage at the show. According to Fightful Select, TikTok and social media stars, the Voros twins are scheduled to be in attendance. This after being photographed with Chris Jericho on Tuesday night on their Instagram. The twins have an impressive following on social media, with them currently sitting at 2.8 million followers on TikTok, with them working independent shows in Canada this year. They've wrestled since 2014, with perhaps their highest profile appearance taking place on an episode of Ring of Honor television in early 2019. On top of this, Fightful confirmed that independent wrestling standout Jody Frecht was booked for the tapings as far as a couple of weeks ago, and is expected to be there at the Canadian shows. Jody would undergo a WWE tryout during SummerSlam week of 2019, and even helped Trish Stratus get in in-ring shape, ready for her match with Charlotte Flair at the pay-per-view. There's no word on if the three wrestlers have signed with AEW as it stands, although the Voros twins in particular could bring a bunch of new eyes to the product if they were snapped up, whilst Jody Frett seems to be a solid overall worker for the women's division. But what do you make of the potential new AEW signees, and could the Voros twins be AEW's answer to Logan Paul? Let me know what you think in the comments down below. And before you go, make sure you check out 10 things you didn't know about AEW's Danhausen.